Hi, good afternoon everyone. Thank you for joining to the last section of the technical track of Meet Magento Indonesia 2020 transformation, digital transformation tomorrow today. Okay, this is the last section and the topic will be more exciting. Do you feel like your Magento 2 size is too big? Because after this is the right person who will help you really have experience and involved in various activities in the fields of Magento 2, Linux, React, Docker, and all related technologies. This includes architectural consults, developer training, open source development, even organization, performance audit, and so much more. Sorry about my internet connection. I'm back, everyone. No worry. So basically, the last session from this topic will become from a founder of the Yirio. As you know, Yirio is an internet company, home of many Magento 2 extension, offer high quality training, consultancy, and tools for e-commerce developer, specializing in and view. Please welcome Mr. G. Sirisma, a founder of Yirio. The stage is yours.
Yeah, thank you, Puteri, for welcoming me. Great to be part of this online conference at Meet Magento Indonesia. So I would have loved to come down to Jakarta itself, but there's circumstances to deal with. And let me actually share my screen so that we can all see the presentation that I was preparing actually for this conference. So my talk is about downsizing Magento 2, and as Puteri already mentioned this, it's kind of like the technical approach. So hopefully I'm going to tell a couple of things that might be useful to your own Magento project, or maybe you're a developer or an agency, and then maybe this is just giving extra incentive to actually do something different with Magento, because basically, we know that Magento is full of features, but it might not always be that you need to roll out all of those features. So Magento is a complex application, and let's focus upon basically how to downsize Magento for performance reasons. So yeah, I already had a little bit of a presentation of who I am. My name is Jisse Rijtsma. I'm from the Netherlands, founder and owner of a little company. The introduction that was already given is basically that I'm spending my days with training backend developers, frontend developers, and also organizing a couple of events like Mage Test Fest, like Reacticon. And our Reacticon was actually supposed to take place last summer in the Netherlands. But unfortunately, Corona happened, the crisis that we're still in. But Reacticon 3 is still going to take place in a couple of weeks' time, similar to Meet Magento Indonesia, free and online. So feel welcome to join. Now, additionally, besides all of the things that I've been doing, I'm making myself a little bit nervous for what is coming up next. Saya suka segalanya di Indonesia. Dan saya bicara bahasa Indonesia sedikit-dikit. 20 tahun dahulu, 20 tahun dahulu, saya belajar bahasa dan saya suka Indonesia banyak. But yeah, that's I think it. Saya lupa kata-kata banyak dan saya bicara bahasa yang kanak-kanak mungkin. Anyway, so that's a little bit of Indonesian, but I'll just go ahead with my presentation itself in English. The focus that I wanted to have was basically on the technical side of Magento itself. And if we focus upon Magento, often we refer to the marketing numbers, like how many times Magento has been downloaded, how many times Magento shops are being built, how much money is being made. Rather, I would like to approach it from a more technical side by sticking to a couple of the numbers on a technical perspective. So if you download and install Magento nowadays, you install 519 composer packages. And this is kind of a lot. You always need a good internet connection. You need a lot of resources to simply just get going with the core. And now within these 519 composer packages, there's actually 346 modules as of yet that could be enabled within the Magento application. And this number of modules has been growing over the years, which might be excellent news. So there's more and more features added to Magento. But the main point I would like to make here is that maybe some of the features are wonderful to use, but some other features are actually less needed. And then still, if you enable all of those features, if you enable all of those different Magento modules, then it's slowing down the application, but it's also leading maybe to weird little bugs or shortcomings, issues that you might have because of a certain module. And then if you're not even going to use that module for your own shop, it's kind of like a silly thing. So that's basically the point I want to focus upon. Magento has a lot of great features, but not all of those great features might be needed in your case. So for instance, there's a GraphQL API. To me, as a backend developer and a frontend developer, this is excellent news because thanks to GraphQL, you can connect a Magento backend application towards a React or Vue frontend. So from a developer point of view, this is excellent news. However, any kind of shop that is currently being rolled out and it's that shop is not based upon React or Vue, it's not a headless architecture, might include all of those GraphQL endpoints while actually they're not needed. And if something is not needed, why not remove it? Another point might be the multi-source inventory. I'm going to talk about this in a bit as well. But since Magento 2.3 came out, this inventory system was on board. Excellent news again. But if you're not going to use it, what to do then with those modules? And then on top of it, there's this thing called bundled extensions from Amazon, Braintree, Dotmailer. Great companies with great solutions. However, not every shop is needing all of these different modules themselves. So actually, if you would focus upon all of this functionality, the logical question might pop up, hey, how do I disable a certain functionality? How do I disable a certain module? Simply to prevent issues or complexity or bugs arising from those modules being enabled. Which is leading actually into my first practical approach. So removing modules could be done in multiple different ways. And one of the ways that any kind of Magento developer should be familiar with is the following. From the command line, you can open up a shell towards the Magento root. And then within the Magento root, you can type in the command module disable, followed by the name of the module. Now, this is kind of like a silly example, of course, because there's a foo underscore bar module. So in real life, it might look a little bit more like the following. And as you can see, this is kind of like a hefty collection already of different modules that you might want to disable. And I put it carefully, you might want to disable this. Because if, for instance, you're going to use the Magento Google Optimizer, which is here in this listing, in this command, obviously you're not going to disable it if you're actually going to need it. The company called IntegerNet, who I consider to be good friends of mine, They wrote a blog post. Later on, I'll share these slides with you so that you can look up the various resources yourself. But they started to write about this this matter a long time ago already, since the release of Magento 2.0. And they came up basically with a combination of modules that you could safely disable. Well, in a similar way, you could also lead into a little bit of shell magic. So from within the command line, you can just play around, for instance, with backticks. Within backticks, you can include a command that is now dumping the output of all of the different modules that are available in Magento, grabbing them, filtering them by the keyword GraphQL. And then basically with this one-liner, you can disable all of the different GraphQL modules. And first off, I simply would recommend you to consider this. Remove all of the different modules that you're not going to use. But there's an additional step here. And basically, that's leading into the fact that if you're going to use Magento not only on a developer environment, but in a production environment as well, most likely or recommended, you're going to roll out this site by using Composer. And if still all of the Composer modules for GraphQL are included in that Composer installation, then maybe in the end, you're not going to use those GraphQL modules, but they're still going to be included in the source code, which is leading into a slower deployment and et cetera. So actually, instead of just disabling the modules, replacing them with nothing might be actually a much better way. And this is kind of like a silly thing because it's referring to a command within the composer.json files, so the composer.json file of your own Magento project, by replacing a certain module with, well, something else, or in this case with a wildcard, you're actually going to remove that module altogether. And the benefit here is that you can just include this little line in your own composer.json as part of your own Magento project. And then in effect, actually, because of this line, the marketplace module will never be deployed towards a production site. And you don't even need to disable that module from the command line anymore because the module is not there. There's no module called marketplace anymore. This is basically the follow-up of that earlier conversation, which is also leading into a similar listing of all of these different Composer packages that you could safely disable, remove actually from your Magento installation. And that's awesome news. But this is leading actually into a little question mark, or kind of like a study. What do you need and what don't you need? So there might be various core extensions that you can safely remove. All of those bundled extensions that I just displayed as well are something that you might just want to remove. Or GraphQL if you don't want to have a PWA shop. But once we hit, for instance, this point of the MSI module set, it becomes a little bit more awkward because MSI since Magento 2.3 has been the official replacement of the legacy inventory. So disabling it either means that you're falling back to the legacy inventory management. And now we're with 2.4, the inventory management, the category inventory is still deprecated, but it might be removed actually from 2.5. And then simply just removing MSI as well, make sure that you actually end up with zero inventory, and that's where most likely things are breaking apart. Well, because of this reason, because of this difficulty, I started to play around with the replacement tricks that originally were invented by this company called Internet. And thanks to that early work from them, I simply created a couple of Composer packages that include basically the replacements that we just discussed. So by installing a package like Magento 2 Replace Bundled, automatically, all of the bundled extensions are removed from your own Magento installation. Content staging, likewise, the core, the GraphQL bit, but the inventory is still in there, but the replacement of the inventory with nothing doesn't actually tell you what to replace it with. So take note that actually it might be dangerous to just copy all of these commands into your own installation and just use it, because it might be that a little bit too much has been replaced. Don't shoot me, don't shoot the messenger. I'm just bringing in the good news that at least there's this ability to replace things. But my big warning is basically use this with care. Study what kind of setup that you're running actually would allow for which packages to replace. And specifically at this moment, a couple of the core packages might be a little bit more dangerous simply because you use those core replacements or you use those core modules themselves. And likewise, the inventory, because the original inventory is deprecated. But at least it's giving some thought. Not everything that is included within Magento is always a good idea. And now with Magento 2.4, I'm sure that you've noticed Elasticsearch has become the default full text search engine for Magento. And in Magento 2.3, this was already the case, but then actually the MySQL search, the original search, was deprecated. With 2.4, it's actually removed, kind of like forcing people to upgrade to 2.4, but then also upgrade to Elasticsearch. Well, personally, I maintain a Magento shop that doesn't need search in the first place. So I'm going to look into how to also replace Elasticsearch with basically nothing, removing Elasticsearch effectively from the Magento core. And it might not be the best of ideas because then you don't have a search ability anymore. But it's kind of intriguing to see that instead of just taking everything that Magento is offering us, you might also just consider removing modules because you don't need them. That's kind of the first part of my story. The second part of my story actually goes into another level of things that you might remove from the Magento core. And I always illustrate it basically by opening up a sample Magento site, a demo site, as you like. And then within that Magento site, there's often a little HTML tag referring to a calendar.css file. Now, the weird part is I'm always trying to do a game basically with the people that I explain that little thing, that once you see the HTML mentioning a calendar.css file, I'm challenging you basically to search for that calendar in real life on the site. And most likely you're not going to find a calendar on the front end. In other words, in short, the calendar CSS is there, but the calendar effect that you would use it for is actually not to be found. In other words, maybe it's better to remove that calendar.css file. Well, as a front-end developer, you should be familiar with the XML layout. And then thanks to simple XML layout statement like the following, removing the calendar.css file, you're able to remove that CSS if you're not going to use it. And this is something that I think a lot of developers and a lot of agencies are already aware of. But there's more. There's more things that could be removed as soon as you focus upon that and realize that actually you might not need it. For instance, the gallery.css file is actually not used that much anymore by the Magento gallery, or theoretically you're just removing the product gallery with another gallery, and then basically this gallery CSS needs to be removed. So by inspecting the HTML source, you can maybe find out other CSS parts or blocks that could be removed in a similar way. Then if you look at things from a distance, it might be that actually of all of the things that you're going to replace, the JavaScript is always the most troublesome and the most difficult because of the heavy layered JavaScript system of Magento. So Magento is using Knockout and Require, and then on top of it, a little bit of jQuery and Magento logic itself. And it's always kind of difficult to go through all of those JavaScript resources and to find out what you need and what you don't need. Well, personally, I'm experimenting with this just to see how far you can get. So for instance, these four little or five little lines that are now replaced with JS/0, which is just a little zero functionality script. But thanks to that their script is loaded once, replacing these five sources on the left with the same zero script on the right, the performance simply just goes up. Well, the first entry is the calendar.js file. And I mentioned this already in the CSS part. If you don't need that calendar.css, you're not likely going to use that calendar.js as well. Another point is that within the Magento backend, you're going to use grids all over the place. And a grid of orders or a grid of products allows for filtering. And there's all of these nifty little JavaScript libraries allowing for that. But on the front end, we don't need that. Well, most likely. So if your front end doesn't need any kind of backend kind of filtering, then theoretically this UI JavaScript file could be removed. And I'm putting it carefully again, because in my case, this is working, but in your case, this might be different. It's depending upon your configuration. It's depending upon the third party modules that you install as well. In a similar way, polyfill is just making sure that all the browsers like IE6 are still working. Well, I don't care about Internet Explorer anymore, so I'd rather just remove that file altogether. Inline translation, CAPTCHA, it's all these little examples that once you start studying them, it might lead into that you're able to remove JavaScript files from the front end altogether, and therefore actually just improve downloading times on the front end as well. So again, this is something that I consider an experiment. I'm working also upon upgrading jQuery 1 to 3 with little benefit, upgrading Knockout to require to the latest version with basically zero benefit. But it's an experiment. And in that experiment, I'm also foreseeing that if you really want to downsize the JavaScript usage on the front end, there's more things that you could do. For instance, know that the current front end is using a menu that is driven by JavaScript, mainly because the CSS techniques of older browsers are not allowing for CSS only menu. But nowadays, that's not an issue anymore. So theoretically, by just replacing that menu with a CSS only menu, you're again removing unneeded JavaScript from the front end. In a similar way, the breadcrumbs are driven by JavaScript. To me, that would be just totally unneeded. And if you're going to save maybe 5 kilobytes or 10 kilobytes simply by just turning this into a separate plain only HTML, that would be a better case, I guess. And in short, basically, this is leading into that I'm trying to sum up all of these ideas of replacing JavaScript and CSS parts within this theme, which I now label optimized theme. Don't use it. Don't just copy the source and start using it. Instead, inspect the source and learn from the ideas that I've put into it. It's not a dummy-proof theme. It's basically kind of like a developer skeleton that hopefully you can benefit from. Now I'm the different image sizes, how to optimize it. So personally, I've developed a WebP extension that allows you to translate JPEGs and PNGs into a modern format called WebP. And I'm actually considering also turning this into more like a more abstract extension as well, using other formats like AFIF and JPEG, even though those formats are kind of difficult to get going with on a average hosting platform, but it's shaping IDs, and that's the main thing that I wanted to present you in this talk. Getting up with better IDs to deal with your front end. Now, as mentioned in the beginning, a little teaser just to mention, like there's more of this coming up. In October 13th and 15th, so in about a month from now, there's this Reacticon online conference with a heavy focus upon Vue and React, but there will be other stuff as well. It's free, it's online, so you're welcome to join the Slack space or just watch the live streaming when it comes up on these dates. And there will be kind of like more stuff that I've just presented, but basically not by just me, but multiple other developers. So hopefully that's something cool to learn from. The main bottom line that I wanted to give you guys is that the Magento front end sucks, but you can make it suck less. Well, maybe that's a little bit harsh. So let's rephrase this. Don't just use what Magento is offering you, but realize that Magento is open source and we can customize it, and we can customize it specifically to fit the needs that we have, instead of just borrowing everything that there is in that system. Well, hopefully I created a couple of IDs. Thank you for listening. If there's any questions, I'm not sure if we still have time for that. But otherwise, you can find me on Twitter. You can find me online, and I'm happy to get in contact with you to share the IDs that we have. Thanks.
Thank you so much. Very, very good presentation, GZ. I just realized Magento have 519 composer packages and 346 modules. Wow, that's a lot. I mean,
it sounds ridiculous, but it's a good purpose. So it's a lot of cool functionality, but we don't always need everything. That's the main point I wanted to make.
Yeah, but since there is no question from the others, so I might have a question for you. So do you have like a list of the modules, or I don't know, a clue what we don't need? Because sometimes the modules are really related with the others, so disabling one can make a breaking the other one. So maybe you have a recommendation, something like this one or this one maybe.
Well, so what I'm trying to do is basically with the GitHub modules that I mentioned, I'm trying to split up the functionality. So for instance, if you don't need GraphQL, you can just remove everything and nothing will break. But it's kind of like depending on like which area you want to remove. I truly hope that I find some time to document this or to lead into kind of like a package that you can always install, another package that you might want to install, and a package that you're never going to install because that's too experimental. But yeah, it's still difficult also on my side to find out what is safe to remove.
Yeah. So do you think how long do we need to do this? I mean, how long does it take if we want to like doing a searching for, I don't know, trial and error in some area, in some part, based on your experience, how long does it take?
Yeah, so first of all, Magento is moving into a service-oriented architecture. So maybe in Magento 2.5, we don't need replacements like these at all anymore. On the other hand, I think like 2.5 is still some time away. We're still dealing with 2.3, 2.4 and older. So my guess would be that it's not that bad to actually start experimenting with it. My experience is basically the composer packages that I mentioned, the stuff that you can remove safely is something that only takes about 5 minutes time, and then you're good to go. The real difficulties are basically with the JavaScript system, so the second half of my presentation, and that's not easy. So I'm talking together with other people on how to make that the effort the most generic for everyone, but that's really hard. Every project has different needs. As soon as you have a preference for a certain extension provider, some of the other tricks don't work anymore. My real recommendation would be start discussing with the rest of the community which packages would be best to remove, which JavaScript do you actually need, maybe come up with joint efforts to replace original Magento components with other components, etc.
Sounds promising. Okay, anyway, we have a question here. Do you contribute in Magento community as well, such as found bugs on Magento and report it? I believe yes.
This Well, this could be somebody of the Magento core team pushing me a little bit, maybe to say like, hey, you're not contributing to the enough. So for sure, like I'm contributing through presentations like these, all of my GitHub repositories. But the downside is a little bit that I always lack time. So I'm busy with so many different things that I'm not fixing that many bugs in the Magento core lately anymore. I've done that in the past, but yeah, so the answer honestly would be no, not really, because of circumstances, but I consider it also a good idea to get going with that again on the short term.
Okay, I believe we have some question, but I think we need to wrap up. Thank you so much, DC, for sharing. It feels like have heavy problem has been lifted from our shoulder. Hopefully everyone can feel the same. Hopefully. Okay, then I wish we can see you in Indonesia maybe next year on the next event. Yeah. Hopefully.
Would be awesome if I can make it. And if yeah. The circumstances allow for it.
Yeah, I wish. Okay. Yeah, thank you, DJ. Thank you so much. Yeah, bye-bye.